Welcome back, guys. This is the second video from the last one. So in the last one, I showed you guys how to make the grass and the flowers from scratch. Then I gave you some textures for it. So, and then I told you guys I'll be showing you how to make level of details for this. So in this video, we will do that. So first, you open the file that we saved last time. Then we can delete these extra flowers on the sides. We don't need those. Then you want to select these flowers, these three. Then you want to go into Modifier tab, add modifier, look for decimate, and then down here type 0.14, enter. And now basically it's reduced the tris count and everything, so so this will be our first level of detail. Okay, next thing you want to do is you want to press tab, press A to deselect everything, and then C, it's just select one of the flowers, all the vertices, one of flowers. Press P and then separate by selection. So click on selection. Then you want to press tab again. Select this flower right here. You want to go down here, go into texture. And now you want to look at the flower from the top and then left click right in the center and then Control Shift Alt C. And the origin is moved exactly in the middle, which is good for us. So now what I'll do is I'll just move this down a little bit so it touches the stem. And then rotate. Doesn't matter which side, as long as you can see it from the sides, it's fine. So you want to do the same thing again. You want to click this, press tab, select one of the flowers. Doesn't matter which one right now. Just use C to select all of these things, and then press P and then selection. Then press tab again to select this flower. Now you look at it from the top, and right in the middle, and then Shift Control Alt C, and we're done. So, and then you want to move this down as well, just so it touches the stem. Then just rotate it. Doesn't really matter which side again. You guys warned, you guys could move it on this side or... You guys can press R, Y, X or Z to move it on any axis you guys want. Let's move it like this a bit. Yep. And then same thing with the last one, only that you're not going to tab mode anymore. Press A to deselect. Left click right here, and then left click to select the flower, and then Control Shift Alt C, origin to 3D curve. Then move this down a bit as well, just to make sure it touches the stem, and then rotate on the side. Now once you've done that, you can just go ahead and apply the modifier by selecting each of them one at a time. Apply, apply, apply. So now our first level of detail is ready. So what you want to do is, as you guys can see down here, 62 tris count and 58 faces. If you guys follow the instructions, your one should be the same. But before we actually send this off now, you want to select everything. And then make sure you press Shift C to make sure your origin, your main point is in the middle. And then Control Shift Alt C, origin to 3D cursor. And that's it. Now what you want to do is you want to save this right here, save as. I'll call this flower and grass. I already have this saved, so I'll just save it on top. The flowers and grass, LOD1. Save this. So this will be our backup when we want to make the any more level of details. You can always come back to this one rather than having to go back to the original file. Then you want to go into file, export, FBX. Same thing, flowers and grass, LOD1. And then export FBX. Okay, so guys, so the LOD1 that we just made, if you guys close it, just reopen it. Now what you want to do is click on the grass, right click, go to materials tab, make sure you have the same color selected as your grass in Unreal Engine. You can go into the solid mode so you can see which color this is, and for me this color is okay. I'm just gonna stick to this color, and then click on the flower right here, scroll down. Turn on transparency, turn alpha down to 0, and then go into the texture tab, add new. So from down this drop down right here, choose your white flower or whichever flower you guys are using, and then scroll down underneath diffuse, press alpha. Now if you press shift Z, you guys can see that the shape of our flower is actually there. You only can't see it because there's no light in the scene right now. So the next thing we do is we go shift A, lamp, and then add a sun, and then drag this up straight up, then on the y-axis, and then rotate it on the x-axis. So press R and then X, and then focus it on the plant. Then I will turn on my screencast so you guys can see what I press. And then when this is done, you want to press Shift A, Mesh, Add a Plane. Now I'm going to first view, pressing numpad 1, and then press R, then X, then just type 90. And you have rotated just 90 degrees. Now I'll move this up to the red line, bottom. Just move it there, and then Control Shift Alt C, Origin to 3D Cursor. Now I'll just make this smaller, and on the x-axis as well. And once you've done this, you want to select this, the plane, and move it back so it's behind all the grass. Now if you press 1, go to the front view, go to the materials for the plane, add a new material, and choose something that's not actually in the scene right now. So I'll choose a red color right here, just a bright red color. Okay, once you've done that, you want to move your mouse away, just left click anywhere, go to window, save screenshots, and we'll call this flowers and grass LOD2. So just call LOD2 and then just save. Once you've done that, now I will be using GIMP. GIMP is just like Photoshop. Don't worry if you guys don't have it, I will attach the file on the website so you guys can right click and say save the link as, and you will have the file. But I will be showing you guys now how I use GIMP. So if you guys ever want to use GIMP, you guys will know what to do. So now I've opened GIMP. I'll go into File, Open, and I'll find my my flowers and grass LOD2 PNG that I just saved in Blender. I'll open this right here, and now this screen will open. So now I will select the crop tool, just drag a box around, making sure I get all of the grass and the plants in. You don't want any of the gray bits in it. So once you have that, that's it. Select and then just press enter. And now you just have this bit left behind. So once you've done that, what you want to do is you want to go into the layer, right click here, add alpha channel. So this will add the transparent channel behind it. Now I will choose this select by color tool, click on the red color, and then press delete. Now we have a transparent background. Now as you guys can see, if you guys hold control and then scroll in to zoom, there's still red bits left around here. So just zoom in, click on the red, press delete. Just keep doing this until all the red is gone. And once it looks good enough, for me this is fine now. And what I'll do is click on select and then none. So you have nothing selected anymore. In fact, I'll just do this once more to delete some more red. Okay, this is fine now, so select and then none. After you've done that, what I'll do is I'll go into image, scale image. I'll just scale the top one down to 100, and the bottom one should automatically be done once you press enter. So once I've scaled this, I like scaling my textures low because no one's going to see this. It's going to be really far away from the player, and it helps with saving performance. So this is one tip you guys should keep in mind. Firstly, I know mine is not squared, but your textures should be squared, and the lower you have them, the better your performance should be, as far as I understand. So now when you're done here, just click on File, Export As, and I will save this as, I will call this Flowers and Grass LOD2. You guys can give it a different name, but I will call this Alpha at the end so I know that it has a transparent background. And then export, and then just export, and we're done here. Now back in Blender, if you haven't closed it, it's fine. If you guys close it, close the file, it's still okay. Just follow my steps from before in the grass LOD2, and then what you want to do is, if you haven't closed it, just right click on this, go into solid mode, then right click on this, press 7, move it exactly in the middle, and then make sure your plane covers the whole grass again, but this time you want it to be in the middle. You don't want it behind the grass, you want it to be in the middle. And what you want to do now is, you want to go into front view, press 1, delete this material. So right here, you want to open the new window, press Shift C, go to middle. And then press Tab, go down here, view the image editor, press U and then unwrap. Once you've unwrapped it, you want to open, and you want to bring in your alpha image that you just made in GIMP. Now you go into object mode, and if you look into texture, you will see that we have the image on this now. So press 1 again. Now we can just delete this grass and delete all the extra flowers that we have. So carefully select and delete all the extra flowers. If you do anything wrong, just press Ctrl Z and then do it again. We can also delete our sun now. Okay. Now what you want to do is you can move this to the middle. Just move this to the middle a bit. It's fine. And then press Shift D to duplicate. And now press R Z and type 90 to rotate on the Z axis 90 degrees. And now we are done. So our LOD 2 is now done. Now what we'll do is we'll go into File, Save As. We will call this LOD2, the same name, just LOD2. Then go into File, Export as FBX, just same name, and LOD2.FBX, Export. And now we will go to Unreal Engine. So, and then inside Unreal Engine, we will go back to just where we left off yesterday. We will open this flower right here. In LOD import, we will click on import LOD level 1. And then choose our LOD level 1 here. And then go back to the LOD import. And in LOD level 2, we will choose our LOD 2. And close this. And now what you want to do is you want to go back, go and import, and import our flowers and grass LOD2 alpha that we made. So right click, create material, open this up, not this one, open this up, and then connect this to opacity masks, and change the blend mode to masked, use two-sided, and then save. Now you want to go back into the flower, zoom out, down here, drag your LOD thing, and you can see it's kind of working out okay for now. And then for the LOD one, you want to drag your flower, and we have all three LODs working. So just before we finish that, you want to go down to auto compute LOD distances, turn this off, and change the value for LOD 1 to 0.001, and then for LOD 2 to 0.0001. And now we have our LOD set up, so as I move away, you guys can see that these triangles will change. Now change 62. Now when I'm really far away, it's changed to down to 4. So this is how you guys make level of details. And when you guys actually paint these on the scene, you guys can drag this on here. And then you guys can also set up a culling distance. So when you move away that much distance, the object will be culled from the scene. Well, thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you next time.